Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Sivanos HD. If this is your first time here, as always, kindly click on the red subscribe button to subscribe to this channel and also click on the bell icon for notifications. Whenever I drop new videos, you always stay updated and notified, guys. Don't forget to also follow me on Instagram with @masterblessed. I really appreciate it. Follow me there. Let me know the kind of videos you want to see, and you can also talk to me about anything over there. So Ada Jesus is dead. She died a few days back, and a lot of people are blaming Odumeje and Rita Daniels for her death. You know, Odumeje and Ada Jesus had an issue where Ada Jesus said Odumeje is fake, and he fakes all his miracles and all those kind of stuff, and that Rita Edoche assists him in doing all these stuff. And Odumeje was not pleased with this, and he laid a curse on her. And a lot of people are saying it's because of the curse that Odumeje laid on her that is making her sick, and they pleaded to Odumeje to forgive her and pray for her, you know, those kind of stuff. In fact, this is how the whole matter started.
Popular comedian Mesoma Mercy Obi, also known as Ada Jesus, was reportedly dead on Wednesday after a prolonged illness. Before her death, the comedian has leveled some allegations against controversial pastor Chukwuemeka Odumeje, founder of Mountain Holy Ghost Intervention Deliverance Ministry Onitsha, also called Indaboski or Liquid Metal. In a viral video, Ada Jesus alleged that the Anambra-based prophet connived with an actress, Rita Edoche, to stage fake miracles. However, months after she made the allegations, Ada Jesus was diagnosed with a kidney problem that left her incapacitated. A friend of hers, Ella Ada, posted pictures of Ada Jesus in a pitiable condition, soliciting for prayers. She posted on Facebook, "Please pray for Ada Jesus. She's really sick and she has a kidney problem. She has been admitted to hospital. Please, let's pray for her. Ada, nothing will happen to you in Jesus' name." Recently, the family of the comedian who was paralyzed took her before Odumeje for deliverance, but it was reported that the cleric and Rita Edoche rejected her. Instead, they lay curses and abuses on her. Indaboski, as the prophet is popularly called, was seen in the video refusing to pray for the sick Ada Jesus, vowing that her generations will suffer for the insult and lies. Some people have alleged that her ailment was as a result of her accusation against the prophet, but he vowed not to forgive her until she proved evidence to support her claims. "You people must bring to me the people that I do fake miracles with. If not, I am done with her. I will start with your generation," Odumeje said in a video of his speech that emerged online. The cleric accused the comedian of ruining his image with false accusations on social media. However, Rita Edoche was present in that video and was heard vowing not to forgive the comedian. She was hurling abuse at Ada Jesus. "You will go from here. You will die from this so others can learn," Rita Edoche said in Igbo. However, on Sunday, April 11, 2021, the actress in a video released on Instagram revealed that she had forgiven Ada Jesus for spreading false allegations against her and Odumeje. She said, "I am here to tell you all that I have forgiven Ada Jesus from the bottom of my heart. I have forgiven you, Ada Jesus," she said in the almost 3-minute video. "Stop insulting men of God, particularly my man of God, Prophet Chukwuemeka Onaimere Odumeje. Use him to respect me. He's good for me. That is why I am with him," she stated. "Stop mocking me because I am following Odumeje. Whatever anyone is comfortable with, let them do. I am comfortable with staying with him. Look for a good place to stay and leave us alone."
Days after celebrating her birthday with her well-wishers from a sick bed, Ada Jesus is pronounced dead. The embattled screen diva, who suffered from an acute kidney problem, has been hospitalized for a while before finally kicking buckets. This is coming days after Ada Jesus reached out to everyone that she once made mockery of in her comedies to ask for forgiveness, one of which is the controversial man of God, Prophet Odumeje, who refused to forgive her until some days before her passing. The news of her death is confirmed through the British Broadcasting Corporation, BBC Pidgin, by Harrison Guashimu, one of those looking after her in the hospital. May her soul rest in peace. Amen. Now, a lot of people, a lot of Nigerians on social media are saying that Odumeje and Rita Edoche should be arrested for the death of Ada Jesus, saying that they are the cause of the death and all those kind of stuff. Nigerians react to the death of popular comedian Ada Jesus as they insist that Pastor Odumeje, who bragged about cursing her, should be arrested. Ada Jesus passed away from severe kidney disease. Her death was confirmed today by one of her caretakers in the hospital. As Nigerians mourn the death of the talented young lady, some insist that Prophet Odumeje, aka Indaboski, should be locked up. for publicly declaring that he was behind her predicament as a result of ridiculing him in her comedies of doing fake miracles. Odumeje, however, forgave her eventually and offered the sum of 1 million naira. In fact, let's take a look at some reactions from Nigerians about this matter on social media. They said at least she made peace with everyone before passing. And that person said that pastor that took credit of her affliction should be arrested. And that person said, thank God you made peace with everyone before dying. That's what matters the most. You are in a better place. Heaven giving your heart to the Lord. And that person said they should have kept her recovery so secret. And that person said, so sad. It's better than the pain she's going through. What do you think about this, guys? Do you think Odumeje should be arrested? And do you think she should have just kept her illness a secret and hope maybe she would have gotten well if she had kept it a secret? And maybe she would have gotten well if she had kept it a secret. Do you also think that way too? Let us know your own opinion about this matter, guys, in the comment section. Still on the update, a lady says that any man that removes protection during intercourse without his partner's permission should be jailed. A Nigerian lady on Facebook identified as Oge Nisima took to her Facebook to advocate for a jail term for men who intentionally pull off condom used for protection during intercourse without the permission of their partners. She revealed that it is fraud and wicked for a man to carry out such bastardized acts. This is coming after the lady revealed that a friend is pregnant because her boyfriend pulled off the condom without her knowledge. Here's what she wrote. I seriously think it should be considered and signed into the law. The act of removing condom during intercourse without proper permission from their partner or knowledge should be punishable by a jail term. It's kind of invading someone's privacy. It's abnormal. It's a fraud. A girl who got pregnant through this selfish act called me a few seconds ago. The worst and the most annoying part of it all is that the young man who is responsible for it is telling her to go for abortion, saying he's not ready to father a baby. This guy must be very stupid. Omo, wahala to funeja. What do you think about this, guys? Do you agree with this lady that any guy that removes condom during intercourse should be jailed? Do you agree with her? Let us know your own opinion, guys, in the comment section as always. Still on the update, the crossdresser who was attacked by angry mobs a few days back has come out to talk about the attack. He says that he's ashamed and depressed. Crossdresser who was attacked and ripped naked some days ago by mobs during his video shoot cries out about his mental health. A video that made round on social media some days ago captures the moment a crossdresser was beaten to pulp by a mob over his choice of outfit. This is coming after James Brown debunked claims of being the one attacked while affirming the implication of being assaulted. The victim of the attack has come out to talk about how the incident led him to depression and devastation while recounting how he was ripped off his outfit. First of all, let's take a look at the video of where he was beaten and all those kind of stuff happened to him.
Wait till you come up with soon. Jesus, what's that? Which are we going to leave these people to do what they do? Jesus! Ah! 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 Ah, I want to leave Bamo. Ah, ah! Hey, don't kill this person, no! Yo, don't kill him. When I leave this poor boy now, when I leave him now, hey Jesus,
I don't know what I did to deserve what they did to me yesterday. I don't know what I did. I was only dressed and I was shooting as usual. And this hoodlums passed on me. I don't know what I did. How they pass on me like that? Saying I'm dressed in a few clothes. Yes, what if I'm a cross-dresser? Am I the one that's seen more than everybody? I mean, I was even lucky my friend I was shooting was wise enough to even capture them. If not, I would never see their face. How many valuables are they made up with? I don't understand. Everything is just going south. I'm so depressed. I don't know if I can be able to come out of this shame. Look at the public disgrace that they gave me to all my clothes. They tore my clothes. My clothes, they tore it. What did I do?
What do you think about this, guys? Do you think this crossdresser deserves the beating he got and everything that happened to him? Do you think what they did to him was fair? I don't know why I'm laughing, guys, but let us know what you think about this matter in the comment section as always, guys. Still on the update, Alex Unusual shuns a beggar, like a fan, not really a beggar, who asked her for 10k to buy a birthday cake for her friend. Big Brother Naija housemate Asoga Alexandra, popularly known as Alex Unusual, shuns a fan who begged her for some money to buy a cake for a friend. During the question and answer session on Alex's Instagram page, this fan has requested for 10,000 naira to buy a cake for her friend since she is broke and could not afford it. Responding to this request, Alex advises the fan to look for honorable ways to make money rather than begging. Here is the conversation between the two. The fan asked, "Please, can I get 10k from you? I want to get a cake and gift for my best friend and I am broke." Alex Unusual replied, "Your best friend should understand that you can't afford this at the moment. I'll be pissed as your friend if you are broke. And instead of looking for ways to make money and multiply it, you are looking for money to get me a cake that I'll consume and forget. I am not giving you, my darling, and I hope that you understand. I love you and take what you should take from this reply." What do you think about this reply, guys? Do you think what Alex Unusual is saying makes sense? Do you think the way she replied was necessary? Do you think her reply was fair? Personally, I think if you don't want to give somebody money, you should have just replied this person privately instead of like coming out to like claim that you're a bad guy and all those kind of stuff. But let us know what you think about these guys in the comment section as always. The Simi opens up about the struggle of motherhood and getting bullied by her daughter. Award-winning singer Simi Sola Kosoko, aka Simi, speaks on the challenges of raising her daughter Adejari regarding random bullying acts every once in a while. The mother of one who recently celebrated her birthday affirmed that her daughter, who will be a year old soon, bullies her a lot in a way that she limits her freedom. Taking to her Insta stories, Simi narrated the attitude she got from her daughter while she was trying to enjoy a moment to herself. In her words, "Dija watching Coco Melon and I just opened TikTok for like 2 seconds and some song was playing loud and she just looked at me like, bro, are you for real? And I turned off the app because I was legit sorry. This child bullies me and I feel like it's not okay after this stretch marks." I beg, leave out Simi, let her enjoy her papa house, like let her enjoy her father's house. She has every right to look at you that way. But guys, what do you think about this? Oh guys, am I wrong? Let us know if I'm wrong in the comment section. Still on the update, filmmaker HG2 says that people become emotionally attached too quickly in relationship these days. Filmmaker and music video director Olabode Akorede Olaolufolari, popularly known as HG2, took to his Twitter page to reveal that people get too emotionally attached quickly and then get broken-hearted easily. He revealed that relationships are cool only when people take their time to understand their counterparts first before investing emotionally in them. The filmmaker said that people have intercourse too quickly and become vulnerable, which certainly leads to complications. This is what he wrote. "I feel like nowadays relationships are so rushed and that's why they end so quickly. People have intercourse so quickly. Also becoming too emotionally attached too soon and not being ready to deal with the complications that come after. I'm just saying." What do you think about what HG2 is saying? Do you think HG2 is right? Personally, I kind of feel he's right though in a way. But let us know what you think about this in the comment section. Lastly, speaking about relationships, a lady affirms that loyal men still exist and they are busy building their careers. Young lady argues that despite the rising number of dramas surrounding disloyal men, there is still a yardstick of men that are loyal. Young lady argues that despite the rising numbers of dramas surrounding disloyal men, there is still a yardstick of men that are loyal. According to a Twitter user identified as Preshi Day For You, the struggle for a career is why a lot of men are off the dating market. She said, "Loyal men exist, they are just busy building their careers." Her claims was, however, followed with mixed reactions as some users agree with the opinion while others disagree completely. Somebody said, "Most women don't believe this. They have beclouded their minds with all men cheats that they call the loyal ones pretenders. They have accepted infidelity that their only care is he shouldn't bring her home. Ladies, get rid of such mindset. Let God give you that loyal man. And that person said, I exist, but no woman care if I exist or not. No one cares for a good man like me. That person said, same goes for loyal women. They are busy building their careers. When boats are done building, they won't be sand enough to build relationships, so they settle for less. And that person also said, this tweet sums me up. I met a lady, we get talking along the line. I just say to myself, Ade, do you know what you are doing? You got to concentrate on achieving your dreams and let these girls be. Then I suddenly pull the plug and stop talking to her. But I fear, how will I get a wife? I look he wants. What do you think about this, guys? Do you agree with Preshi? Do you agree that loyal men still exist? Personally, I agree that loyal men still exist. Come on, look at me. I'm loyal. I'm busy making videos for you. Instead of me to be somewhere else cheating on my girl, I'm here making videos. I beg, give me a round of applause. What do you think about this, guys? Drop your thoughts as always in the comment section. That is all for this video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to slap a like on this video. Click on the red subscribe button, subscribe to this channel, and also click on the bell icon for notifications. So whenever I drop a new video, you will be updated and notified. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram with @masterblessed. I really, really appreciate that. Take care, guys. Stay safe. See you later for another video. And peace out.